Hey there, and welcome back to the Parkinson's Disease Education Podcast. In today's episode, we're going to be continuing our conversation about antioxidants, reducing oxidative stress, helping to heal sick mitochondria that we discussed in recent episodes. Today's episode kicks off a series we're going to be doing on supplements as a way to improve Parkinson's symptoms and hopefully help to mitigate cell damage and prevent future cell damage due to oxidative stress and other causes. Now, to kick off this series, we're going to be starting with CoQ10 or Coenzyme Q10, which is a readily available supplement that you could take that could actually help to improve Parkinson's symptoms and, again, reduce overall oxidative stress throughout the body, particularly in the nervous tissue involved with Parkinson's disease. Without further ado, let's start this episode. Roll the music. Go.
Welcome to the Parkinson's Disease Education Show, where we demystify the disease and empower you as the person with Parkinson's disease to reach your true potential. The content contained on this show is for informational purposes only and is not meant to be a replacement for information or advice that you receive from your in-person medical or therapy professionals. If you haven't already, I hope you'll consider subscribing, and for an even more personalized experience, please ask us about our memberships. Now, without further ado, let's start the show.
So what is CoQ10? CoQ10, or Coenzyme Q10, also known as ubiquinone, is a natural antioxidant found in the body. It's actually found in human cells. It's found in the Golgi apparatus, endoplasmic reticulum, and in and around the mitochondria. It's found in the cell, period. In natural levels it's found, but it also can be supplemented, as we're talking about in this video, because as much as oxidative stress can be both natural through processes the body does on its own normally, and also abnormal with external factors such as toxins, stress, and so forth, sometimes supplementation of CoQ10 is necessary to be able to have such a level to notice a difference in symptoms due to oxidative stress and free radicals. Now, how does CoQ10 act as an antioxidant? Well, I think to better explain that, it would be important to see the chemical structure of CoQ10 and how this particular molecule, as well as other antioxidants, tend to work to reduce oxidative stress and to eliminate or reduce free radicals in the body. Now, to do that, I'm going to need my trusty whiteboard, and I'm going to depend on you to help me to get whiteboard to show up. Just a second. All right, everybody. So on the count of three, we're going to clap our hands and we're going to summon magic whiteboard. One, two, three, and there he is. Let me get you in here a little closer so we can look at this. All right, so here's the star of the show, CoQ10 or ubiquinone. So this is the chemical structure and what it looks like. And you'll see over here on the right, there's this bracket that says 10. Essentially, there's basically like 10 of those structures on this chemical molecule. And basically, this structure is stable enough and has its own electrons that it can give away its own electrons in order to stabilize a free radical. What's an example of a free radical? Well, a free radical could be an oxygen that's not bonded to another oxygen. Instead of O2, which is the natural state of oxygen that we breathe, for example, you have O negative. Or you could have other examples like a hydroxyl, which is OH with a free electron that's not bonded to something else. Regardless of what type of free radical it is, they can cause other harmful chemicals in the body, such as hydrogen peroxide, which is caustic and can cause cell damage in itself. So you want to reduce and eliminate those free radicals quickly. And this molecule is stable enough that it can donate those electrons. So in other reduced states of CoQ10, which you'll see, and there's two other states that you'll see this. There's like a between state and a final state after it's accepted other electrons. Typically what you'll see is, instead of this double bonded oxygen, you'll see an oxygen. I lost my pen. I'm back. Instead of this double bonded oxygen, what you'll often find is an oxygen paired with another hydrogen that's been accepted from elsewhere. So the long and the short of it, without getting any more detailed, is that This molecule can help naturally reduce those free radicals by donating its own electrons and creating a more stable state of chemical state in the cells. All right, this calls for a round of applause for Mr. Whiteboard. And I'm glad we didn't clap too loud, because we got to clap one more time to wish Mr. Whiteboard adieu. Remember how we did it before? 3, 2, 1. So I hope that was helpful to at least kind of visualize the structure and how that might help to reduce free radicals. Even if that wasn't necessary, I think it's kind of nice to see it. I'm a visual person. I like to see things like that. But anyway, one of the main issues that I saw come up online was, what about the blood-brain barrier and what levels do you need to take to kind of make a difference? Because the studies that are out there kind of vary, showing the results, especially in PD, of how it could reduce symptoms in those with Parkinson's disease. Future studies need to be done on showing the results, although with any supplement you take, if it works, then do it. And if it doesn't work, there's no harm in trying it. As far as the question of how much to take, you know, the blood-brain barrier is something to be considered, because again, nutrients don't easily pass from the blood into the nerve tissue. And there's a good reason for that. CoQ10 can cross the blood-brain barrier. However, it's just basically what you have to be concerned about is just how much is getting into the brain to make an actual difference. And there's not really any quantifiable way to see that at this time, or not that we've seen in current research. That doesn't mean you shouldn't try it. Again, I would encourage you to try anything you can to make your symptoms better. And so in that light, I want to give you at least one product that I found on Amazon that could be a good way to start. I looked for the best rated ones on Amazon, and I did find one that I'll link in the description below and maybe in a card up this way that you could look for yourself and see what you think. The one that I will link actually has a 4-month supply if you take it daily. And so I would do your own research into quantities to take. I'm not going to recommend one way or the other, but I would say if you're going to try one, look at the one that I link and see what you think, and look at the reviews. I know there's over 53,000 positive reviews. Well, I'll say at least 53,000 reviews overall on Amazon for this product, for CoQ10, and it's like 4.5 stars. So it can't be too bad, right? At least it's a good place to start in your research. I hope this was helpful to you. I will cover another supplement in next episode, and I hope you'll give me feedback on what you thought in this episode, what your experience has been if you've taken CoQ10, and how it's helped you and your symptoms with Parkinson's disease. Wrapping up the video today, thanks for being here. Look forward to seeing you in the next episode, and as always, be empowered.